But I will cut out one that I have over here. Let's see, where is that one? This one is a tetrahedron. And in case you forget, what's nice about this for the sighted person that's helping is that the name, again, is right there, tetrahedron net, so you'll know what it is. Now, what you're going to have your students do is, after you have gone ahead and made these, if you want them to have some fun too, you can let them put it through the machine. But depending on how good a scissor, you know, how good they are with scissors, they can cut the entire thing out themselves. And what I'm saying there is, and I'm going to show you exactly, you would cut around the edges. That's the perimeter. So all we're doing is cutting around the edges. Now, your student should be able to also feel these. So basically, they're going to just start trying to fold along those, what they're feeling there, along those lines. And we got one more here. And you just want to be able to do this so that they'll be able to fold. I mean, this is what they're going to be doing. And, you know, let them play with it for a little while. Have some scotch tape ready. So, in case they want to do it one little bit at a time, they can go ahead. And I'm terrible, by the way, with scotch tape, etc. But I'm going to try to do my best. Let me get the whole thing kind of together to make sure I've got it in here. And let me tell you, your students will be better than me. But anyway, I'm going to try to get this to scotch tape together. And what they've now made, they had that net. Let me do a little more scotch taping. I need lots of scotch tape on mine. And what they have made, you should have seen, I had a workshop and all the participants were running around with their little tetrahedrons and octahedrons, etc. So there is your, see? It should be the same on all sides, except I think it looks a little better from certain angles. There. Oh, I think that angle looks the best. Okay. So you've made your tetrahedron. And believe me, them actually putting that net together is what's so important. Because looking at something like this and figuring it out that it folds up to something like that, it really needs them having that real experience of cutting it up and doing that. What you can also do with these, if you have a bunch of them and a lot of students in the class or whatever, you can take these, and we made a mobile that hung from the ceiling of the classroom. So just in case you don't know what to do with these after you're finished. Okay, so that's all you have to do to create certain nets. And like I mentioned, I have this particular one, which I didn't put together. This is a dodecahedron, and that means it has 12 pentagons, and by the time you put it together, you get this three-dimensional object called a dodecahedron. If you have a shape like this, you fold this all together, and you've got an octahedron.